When you consider all the incredible boasts that religious people have made about Jesus and about his origins, it defies reason that the world, and sadly, that includes those who make the boasts, has so totally ignored him for all of these centuries. At Christmas time each year, emphasis is put on this amazing miracle that we call the Incarnation. What it means is that the creator of the universe somehow took on human form in an effort to reveal his love and his divine plan for us human beings. We humans are his ultimate creation in a universe filled with millions and billions of other fantastic creations. Some scientists argue strongly against the existence of God, but the truth is that scientific research has mostly just revealed how awesomely wonderful our Creator really is, above anything that we could possibly imagine. Our understanding of the universe, and indeed the universe itself, just keeps getting bigger and bigger. I learned recently that what they have so far been able to observe of the universe covers something like 30 billion light years from one end to the other. And they say that's just the start. In fact, now they're talking about other universes outside this one. I won't go into it all here, but if you have any idea about how far light can travel in 1 second, you must know how far beyond normal comprehension even a light hour would be, much less 30 billion years of light traveling at that incredible speed. I mean, even 30 billion years itself is something we cannot adequately comprehend. The Bible says, "The heavens declare the glory of God, and the earth shows forth his handiwork." Now, we have science doing the same thing for us. That is, showing forth God's handiwork in ways that could never have been imagined in Bible times, just by uncovering the intricacies of cells and atoms and every other aspect of life, matter, and even time. Somewhere beyond all that we have so far observed is something called eternity. Now, eternity dwarfs even the billions of years of time and the billions of light years of space that science attributes to the universe now. Yet, the infinite creator of all that is out there, and in here, in the tiniest life forms and in atoms themselves, this creator chose to reveal himself to us, his ultimate creation, and he does it through a little baby who grew up to be a human just like us. This literal Son of God lived and walked on this planet. So my point is, what have we done about that incredible fact of human existence? What are we doing about it? I should think that if we spent even 5 minutes each day pondering the significance of this great revelation of God the Creator in Jesus, it would transform our lives and our world. There's only one reason why it is not happening, and that's because we don't really believe it. Or if we do believe it at all, we just dismiss it from our minds most, if not all, the time. For most of our lives, even the most religious people live as though we were atheists. We squander our existence on trivia, on video games, on frivolous fashions, on worries about what people think of us. We needlessly fear, we needlessly obsess, and we while away our lives on entertainment that leads us nowhere. In fact, we do everything except what matters most of all. We do not appropriately respond to this incredible incarnation that stands at the center of the universe and at the center of time. Why? In the name of God, why? It would be nice to have been there in Bible times when Jesus was here in the flesh. Yet, if we would embrace what he taught, embrace it today, I'm convinced that the same power which revolutionized the world just after his ascension into heaven will have a similar effect on the world in which we live today. We just need to let go of our stunted, crude, egocentric vision of Christianity as a religion as an institution, as a respectable way of life, and as something which makes us better than other people. We need to open ourselves up entirely to the God of the universe. He alone really knows what we need. And he's laid it out for us in the teachings.